Hi everyone, welcome back to Divinity Original Skin, and we're gonna go and kill Victoria, obviously. Me and Ken discussed it long and hard, and we think orcs should die.
Orcs must die, you might say.
Where are you at? What the fuck are you doing here?
To me?
I don't know, I was just wondering where you were. Alright, goddamn.
I'm checking for that summon wolf.
I wish I could speed up, but anyways, So Victoria the Orc is actually happens to be in Mayor Cecil. Sorry, I've been saying Mayor Cecil. That's the name of the town. Basically, he's in the mayor's house in the library. So we're gonna go check out that and see what she's all about. She didn't seem that threatening when we met her last time. So we don't need
seems
to.
Seems like an old deer, actually.
So
we're not old, but nice.
Yeah, she's nice, so we'll just talk to her and tell her about the murder.
Victor's Jagetta, friend.
Let's discuss Eglander the elf.
Kiral is sore. Oh, do pardon my language, my friend. But that is quite the startling revelation. So much sadness, so much anguish. Eglander's tale is heartrending, though it seems that in the pursuit of retribution, he has himself become as great a ghoul as those that wronged him. Does he not see that I am now the one who is to be wronged? Why, oh why, must he make me, of all gentle-minded and life-loving creatures, why must he make me the target of his imperishable hate? Whom have I ever harmed? I live for books, not brutality. So, let us approach the situation with reason and ask ourselves, where do we go from here? Though, first let me say this. Hashizam bil kushum zunum. From my heart, I thank you for warning me. I thank you and I trust you. So pray, let me pose the question. What do you advise we should do?
Oh, we can take the amulet or we can have him arrested. Let's try the amulet, so. If the amulet the elf wants his proof of death, why not just give it to me?
My amulet? But it is Haxmaji, a sacred token that houses the presence of my ancestors. No. I cannot part with my talisman, the keepsake of my soul.
Is a keepsake, no matter how precious, worth your life? Alright, just gotta skip this. Oh, she won the argument.
You may try and trick me out of my amulet, but you will not succeed. I said you shan't have it, and that is final.
Okay. Well, what else can we do?
Yes?
Have
you decided what should be done
I've
about
arrested.
Him?
Can I still
Please
do
not press me any further.
Okay, fine.
With the power of Haxmaji,
I'll have him rearrested.
Yes, a capital notion. Let him be brought before the law for his schemes. I am an innocent, and Eglander here would see me dead. That is a grave offense, is it not? It would probably be better if you rather than I informed Captain Aureus, though. He bears little goodwill toward me ever since my more savage brethren have been marauding the beaches and killing his legionnaires.
Alright, I take my leave. Alright, we're gonna go talk to the captain then. That's a shame, because that we would get the reward if she allowed us to take the. I mean, I don't think the reward is anything special though. Probably just some gold or something. But now we can be fulfilled with the fact that we know that we have justice in our hearts, in mind. Do you feel justice, Kent?
You don't think it's infected?
I feel confused that after all that dialogue, like, hey, okay, this guy wants to kill you. We can ask the question of, who are you?
You, again. Do feel free to depart from Cycele at your earliest convenience.
Someone the Legion should arrest.
Whom would you have the Legion arrest?
We could also do Robert the Mortician for doing the body.
No, that'd be rude.
Fine. Eglander, then.
The elf. What in the name of Ahu's arse should I arrest him for?
He wants to kill Victoria.
He wants us to kill Victoria.
The man is, you know, quite harmless.
It's true. He is a dangerous lunatic and needs to be incarcerated.
So, he wants you to kill that savage the mayor calls his daughter, does he? Hardly seems a crime to do so. But I guess I cannot allow assassinations to take place. I won't arrest him unless I have some actual evidence, though. Or did you think I'd simply take your word for fact?
You don't have any proof yet, though.
As I suspected.
Oh, well, that's a shame. Well, Guess I'll take.
We'll be back.
We'll be back. Guess I'll go back to him. I didn't actually think about that. Yeah, I'm gonna go to Northgate. It's goddamn! Why didn't you just give us the fucking amulet? Maybe we should just.
Because you ordered the fuck. You should have played rock paper scissors.
No, that's. I'm leaving it up to RNG rather than leaving it up to RNG.
It's not RNG. You gotta get into the mind of the computer.
The mind of the computer.
You're just not Neo enough, man.
I'm a programmer. I know how it works. The fucking random number generator. Do you want to do the random number generator that takes slightly longer or slightly shorter is the question.
I bet you if you just picked rock over and over, the game would eventually go, well, he's just gonna pick rock over and over again. I'll pick something that beats rock.
It doesn't, it RNGs it. Can you roll a dice? That's what you do. In either case, one of them is just faster. It's funner when it's like me and you doing it, but when it's just him, no.
So you get in my head?
Here I wait for thee in the dark.
About this since yes. He asked me. Yes. Target, okay, he's just good. We've heard this all. Victoria.
My name is Eglan.
Okay, I don't want to hear this guy. Okay, so unfortunately he's not telling me anything, but does his chest maybe have it or something? We have no evidence, so we can't do it.
The hunters go stalking in the night.
Does he have anything on him?
By the needles.
Maybe we need
to
pickpocket him.
Bleeder, they'll end it all.
You're all brave.
I wait for thee in the dark, but the stab shall bring the light. Minister to death.
Pickpocket failed.
That is what I want of thee.
I'm gonna try and pickpocket him now. If he has something on him. I'm not allowed to pickpocket him. Well, we can't, maybe the desk has something.
He has a bloody amulet.
Oh. I don't know, can you take that?
There's a save. Actually, I can see this.
By the
oh, I have a weight limit on what I can steal. Okay, got you.
Soul shredder. The
and a value limit.
What do you think you're doing?
Oh.
It's
bad because I touched the door. Why? Also, loot the desk. Wait, does he have anything else?
A thunderbolt grenade. Can I take that? I want that.
Thunderbolt grenade. Why would he have that?
It's his great action. I could fucking steal everything from him. I should have been lockpicking sooner.
By the fire. He'd be pickpocketing.
Oh, I hate to get pickpocketing people. That was amazing.
Alright. You need a bloody amulet? Let's see it.
Comes a creeping for you, Victoria!
Oh god, where is it, my inventory?
So, can you check the desk too? Actually, I'm gonna just make Joe and talk to him. You can turn around.
What the fuck?
There's some gold in here. How did you not loot that? Okay, where's the bloody amulet?
I think there it is. Fucking, it was so hard to find. Cause like, at some point I not sold my inventory. You have it now.
Okay, thank you. Alright, well, let me go. I don't know. I don't think that's evidence of anything, though.
Well, look at it.
That's a bloody amulet.
Read the description.
It's a deity called the All-Mother. That's what I mean. I'm gonna show it to... I don't know, can we give it to him? Do you think he'll fall for that?
Wait, this is actually like...
I'm actually curious. Can we just give it to... go like, hey, we got the amulet.
Here I wait for
that's
the
assistance. Yes. My target would be your that. Name, no, it doesn't count. Okay. No dialogue options opened up with the amulet.
What if I pickpocket the amulet from the orc?
That's actually a good idea, but let's see what happens if we can do it with this one right now, because I feel like it has some significance. Actually,
I'm giving that to the dude.
I think that's evidence for the other guy. But you know what? Honestly, I want you to pickpocket the orc actually, because then we get the reward.
So you want to get the reward then, tournament?
Yeah. Let's do that.
I think we can even do that. Say before I do that.
Alright, go pickpocket the orc. My phone's ringing. Okay, I'll take this while you do that.
The knight in see-through armor, Princess Buttercup with the blushing bottom, Stentekel. Esmeralda does have a propensity for all things naughty, hasn't she?
Did you take it?
Yep.
Alright. Do I have it?
Yep, you have it now.
We just don't steal her fucking amulet.
I'm gonna go on a stealing spree now. God damn it, Medora, what are you doing in there?
Pickpocketing is like literally the best thing. Alright.
Medora, stop that!
Here I wait for thee.
About this, since
yes.
He asked me.
Yes. Have you made the orc feel the black and biting cold? Sent her toward the gangling grip of the greedy grey?
Here you go, Victoria's amulet.
Yes. So it is.
You need to load the game.
So it is.
You need to load?
Yeah.
Okay. He was in the middle of dialogue.
Sorry.
I
tried to pickpocket the mayor and like it packed me to walk in front of him.
Yes. So it is. So it is. By Angus the Impaler's favorite stake, you done well by me. Oh, Ravager of Gazaldagar, the last of their line is dead. The House of Gandavon has been avenged. Sweet flowing blood. The quest of decay is at an end. My wealth is yours. My life is death's. By the hollow sockets of the Voidwood Eye Gouger, I bid thee thanks and fond farewell.
Oh, dude, I got a chest here. Dude, there's a chest.
Chest?
Yeah, teleport to me. You have the drug and your rock.
Daemon, daemonium, and so let the...
You know what to do.
Oh!
What's in there?
That's so wrong. Oh.
I'm gonna just teleport.
It's terrible.
North gate. He ran away, but I don't know, maybe we can report him anyways.
It's heating up.
He said farewell, so I think he left town. But we'll be like, stop right there, criminal scum.
You don't think it's infected, do you?
Come on now, I pulled her off you before she could do any real damage.
Alright, time to report this guy to the nearest authorities.
You! Again. Whom would you have the Legion arrest?
I actually can't do it at all. Actually, it's not even an option anymore. So, I think it just never was. Alright, well. You can just sell the amulet then. I mean, it's worth a fair bit.
Hey, we could reload.
No, fuck that. I don't want to arrest him. It's Nick's diary. There's really nothing to that. So I am thinking we will. I'm gonna go find the head, because we know of this quest already.
I'm running towards him.
The cuck here.
I'll figure out who murdered Jake before the day's through. Just you wait. Detective Kip is on the case.
Wow, Detective Kip is on the case. Dude, we have a badass fucking chicken here that's gonna solve the murder, Ken.
Nice.
Actually,
it's safe. Doing stupid things, okay?
Maybe we attack to the Cedric.
You there! Sit! Stay a while! Right in front! I'll excite you.
I'll delight you. I'll beguile you. I'll besmile you. I'm Cedric the Sensational, and I'm playing to an empty audience.
Tell me about yourself.
Don't pity me. No, sir. Just a few years ago, I was the all-singing, all-dancing, all-sensational darling of the town. People came from far and wide just to witness my amazing act. When Reginald came, he brought some fantastic prop with him. Now, have you seen it? A talking head! Now, I never expected a silly gimmick like that to be my main competition.
Tell me about the competition between you and Reginald.
It seems even my usually choosy audience has been taken in by that hack's little gizmo. I'm a man of skill, sleight of hand, feats of wit, and pure entertainment. This curio is ruining what used to be an art. And even when there's no crowd to speak of, old Reggie still has at least one fan calling bravo and hee-haw. Sure as the sun sets, that one devotee attracts five more, and those five more all curious about the commotion. I don't know how he inspires such loyalty with less talent contained between his hat and his boots than I've in my crusty handkerchief.
Take my leave. All right, so this guy is having a competition problem with someone with a talking head. We've met a zombie with no head, so I wonder if they're related. I like you're already here.
May have looted that guy already.
Who?
Reginald took his gold.
You there! Take a seat! Prepare to laugh your head off! Cry your eyes out! And teeter on the edge of your seat! With an original tale from Stefan, the talking severed head!
How about your competition, Cedric?
That he ordered a contest.
Oh, yes, I know of that talentless fool. He was here entertaining the troops before I was brought in. I'm sure the hack simply bored his audience to tears until they cried for a replacement. Enter Reginald the Illusionist! We need our boys in red happy, relaxed, and ready to fight! Not wasting their energies cringing at a fool with a depressed rabbit in a borrowed hat.
Let's talk about your talking head.
That's right, a talking head. And he doesn't just talk. He'll weave you a yarn so fantastic, you'll be begging to hear just one more, and just one more. It's quite a story how I found him, too.
Oh, let's hear it.
I obtained this curio by some rather sensational means. You see, I was diving in search of a rare medicinal sea herb. I volunteer at the local children's apothecary on weekends, in the shallows around Sicil's own Black Cove, when I spotted something amazing. The chest belonging to the fabled Captain Pontius. Though the chest was stock fast, I summoned a swell of great strength and prized it free from the ancient rock. I had the treasure of a lifetime in my very hands, but then, slurp, gulp. I was swallowed by an ornery kraken that seemed to appear from nowhere. In the hubbub, I lost hold of my prize and watched it sink to the bottom of the beast's cavernous belly. Still, I feared only for a moment that all was futile. Before my mind's eye swam the faces of the many war widows and neprotic orphans who would be lost without my charitable support, I knew I had to live. Grabbing fast to the hilt of a cutlass that floated by at just that moment, I summoned all my strength to slash a great gash in the creature's gut. Freeing myself from my would-be tomb, I swam as quickly as I could, first to the surface and then to the shore. It was there, along the rocky beach, that I tripped over this talking head. Strange, isn't it?
Well, I take my leave. Okay, oh, interesting story. Let's talk to the head.
Excuse me, I'm trying to prepare for the next show. Autographs will have to wait until the end.
Tell me about yourself.
I doubt I have to tell you that I am the amazing singing Stefan, the only sentient severed head in Sicile. My audience sings my praises from hill and dale. Psst, you're a source hunter, aren't you? Oh, bless the seven. So you've got to help me. I've been kidnapped. Pleasure to meet you. Now, please, Stefan has many fans to meet today. Psst, to help me. Take me to Reginald's cellar. There I will reveal everything.
If you're ready, I'm going to pick you up now. You wouldn't mind a little ride in my pocket, would you? A fucking head in a pocket. Okay.
It won't be the worst indignation I've suffered. Get on with it, then.
Hey, stop that!
What a tale!
I'll keep things out as they are. Okay, so I can't get rid of him. So... we got a bit of a problem. I want to pick you up, but not with all these watchful eyes about.
What do you call a source hunter who finds a way to draw a crowd away from where he or she
wants
to perform a clandestine operation? A resourceful hunter. Come now, it can't be that hard to find something to draw off the attention of this bleating herd.
So we know from the other guy that there's one of these guys is paid to kind of be here. So let's find out which one it is. I think it's this guy.
Don't ask me what the tale's about. I'm just here for the eye candy.
Not this guy. What this is him. Nope.
Don't ask me what the tale.
Oh,
what are you
back.
Looking at me for? There's a great show going on right in front of you. And look. There stands the world-famous Reginald the Entertainer. Better check it out if you don't want to miss the time of your life.
Oh, tell me about yourself.
Oh, I'm nothing but your average man taking in the best show I've ever seen. I'm amazed and astounded that for a meager gold coin or two, I can take in this first-rate entertainment all day long.
The same show all day, that seems like a bit much.
Well, I've stumbled into quite the fine gig. I just let my appreciation for Reggie's work be known, and he slips me a few gold coins in return. My voice happens to carry pretty far. Cycile hears me. Cycile wants to see what the fuss is all about. And let me tell you, this amazing show just can't be beat.
But he's getting paid to say this stuff. And looks like Candace is finding another way of getting rid of everyone. I wonder, can we pay this guy?
There's a great show.
So I'm gonna go. I guess talk to the other guy. What the hell is this person saying?
Zombie ate your dog. Orcs
and
literally
nothing.
No matter.
Where's the other guy? Ah, he's up here.
You there?
What on earth would an undertaker want with the likes of Huggett?
The fuck is that person talking about? That chicken talking about?
A familiar face. Come, watch the show. I promise it'll take your mind off beheading baddies. Or whatever it is you do with all those muscles.
Haven't you heard? Reginald Dees is a crowd warmer.
Aye. A person whose sole job is to praise the performance and stir the crowd. A genius invention. No wonder Reginald has had such success. I knew his act couldn't have outshone mine on its merits alone. Please, you must hire him for me. Imagine the scowl on that con man's face when my rightful audience returns to me. A must-see event.
All right, well, we'll go hire him then. The hell's this guy want?
You there. Look like an actor just waiting for his big debut.
Oh, yeah.
And who are you supposed to be?
I want to perform a show.
Take it up with Katarina. She's the...
Oh, okay. Katarina.
Enjoying the fair, aren't you?
I'll deal with this later. I want to see if we can make a show. What kind of amazing things could we do, Ken? Oh, my God.
There's a great show going on.
Would you be interested in warming the crowd for Cedric over there?
Well, I don't see why I should. Reginald and I have grown rather friendly, you know? And in any case, it'll be hard to pull myself away from this fantastic show.
Perhaps a hard shove in the proper direction would encourage you to move on. Alright, I gotta skip it. Oh, I won the argument.
Now, no need to get bushy. I'll go give Cedric the old Gallagher treatment if you'll lay off.
Alright.
Oh, I would!
So ardently did he crave creamy blues.
Are you enjoying yourself?
Yes.
My word!
Yes, very.
Ha! Today, I think, a king.
Okay, so the guy's going over here.
My word! Come on! Can't you hear
the stage calling you.
And I was going to go over here and do the same thing. Ah, and now they're all leaving. No, a talking head isn't that person's back. There's packages in the back you haven't looted? Are you fucking crazy?
Packages?
Yeah, right behind.
I can't loot those.
Strange. You appear to be my only client. Did the whole of Sycile eat some bad chicken, or what?
But, let's discuss your crowd warmer.
Aye. These Sicilian cows wouldn't dare chew their cud without the full support of the herd. Without my crowd warmer, I can't attract a crowd for the life of me.
Okay, well, let's talk to the head again.
Do re mi fa sol la ti. Oh, excuse me,
something about
to
the watchful eyes about.
What do you call a resourceful hunter?
Alright, well, is he gonna fuck up?
Where is everyone trotting off to? Don't they want...
Strange! You appear to be my only client! Did the whole of Sycile... I knew that fool could never have garnered so much as a guffaw on his own merits. I'll see to this matter immediately!
So, I told him that Cedric took his crowd warmer, so now we can just take this guy. I'm gonna pick you up now.
It won't be the worst indignation I've...
And we got it! We got the head.
Let me finish my masterpiece, I'll catch up.
Well, that took way too long. Actually, no. It's apparently gonna load
up. You took me with you, dear!
I'm sorry.
I wasn't done playing Jenga.
It's not the black coat we want to do. We want to do the other one that's here. Is it, what is it called? Derelict Harbor? Is it Derelict Harbor?
Yes.
Yeah, it is. Okay. I didn't want to walk through this trap skin.
The body stirs. The subtle slouch in its decayed shoulders suggest intense longing. A large, soggy chunk of flesh falls to the ship's floor with a melancholic thud. So this is what's to become of me, it seems to moan. A body with no head. A ship with no captain.
So about your head.
Nick's body grows cold, then hot. Could it be, after all this time, reunited? Could it be real? Could it be true? Tremors overtake its hands, its knees, and then...
Toes? Legs? Arms? Fingers? A bit more rotten than when I last saw them, but who am I to look a gift self in the mouth? Oh, the feeling of air in my minimally perforated lungs. Well, not quite blood, but lovely ooze pumping through my only moderately decayed veins. What a joy it is, my friend. What an absolute joy. Now for my last unfinished business. Pontius Pirate, the animal who consigned me to the peanut-crunching masses. I won't rest until his skull cracks beneath my foot.
Sorry to burst your bubble, but Pontius is already dead.
Dead? Dead and dead for good? Never to rise again, you're very certain. Well, I would have loved to see him collapse to dust myself, but your assurance is most satisfactory. With my head back on my shoulders and my foes defeated, I owe you a large debt of gratitude, my friend. Here is my pledge to you then. Your enemies from now and forevermore shall be as my own. Call me when you will, where you will, and I will fight beside you. I'm dying to try out my right hook, now that I've got arms again after all. Until we meet again, Source Hunter, I remain your humble bodyguard, eager for your summons.
Okay.
It was Source that drove Pontius mad, yet it is Source that has kept Nick alive to fight his old foe.
Though we are sworn to eliminate it, there is more to Source than simple evil.
Indeed, the Academy taught us far from all there is to know about this strange magic.
Renegade? Uh-oh, shit.
Oh my god. Shit.
We're going edgy. Oh, that increases your pickpocketing, dude.
Oh man, I chose correctly.
I wanted the fucking I wanted righteous, though. That's fine.
Not for leadership. I give a shit.
So I have to not be an edgelord. Alright, well, let's go back to town, then. I don't think there's anything else we need to do in town now.
Actually, the other option was the edgelord option, wasn't it?
No, that was,
The other option was like, yeah, fuck the source. Whereas I was like, well, actually, you know, that guy gets to live now. That's kind of cool. It's not really edgy, that's just like... pretty good.
It's like me, they both sounded kind of similar to me, to be honest. So we basically got everything here, so, oh yeah. Oops. Oh, shut up, Midori.
Nice!
Alright, we have, Summon Nick. So, either you or me, one of your characters would get it, so I'm gonna give it to you. I will never, because I already have two summons, so give it to someone who will never get a summon, which is either Midora or you. I think Midora, to be honest.
Did I just learn this?
Yeah, you just learn it. And then I gave it to Midora last time we played this game. Because
I think I gave it to Midora as well, because I've got scrolls on me.
Yeah, and honestly, you want to be shooting things from long range. Midora will not always be in a situation where she wants to hop in right away, so... And, like, I already have enough summons, so... And I'm going to get more summons, so... I mean, you can only have one summon per character, guys. So that's how we do that. Good job, Midora. And now we can summon Nick to fight for us.
And then you can summon spiders.
I am one again! Command me, my friend.
Have some friends. I think we're done with town, so we got this entire section up here to do next time. We'll probably do that. And not talk to Joanne anymore. There's literally nothing else we got. So that I think the church is somewhere up here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's somewhere up here. So we can kind of have a good sneak peek at what we're up against soon.
Did we not talk to Aru about this failed experiment?
No, I thought we did. I'll talk to Aru then real quick, just to make sure we're done with that. So literally next episode, we're going to jump right into combat and just leave. Because we actually literally have nothing else here. I thought we were supposed to get the head from his basement, though. That's what I thought happened.
That's probably something, maybe like an alternate way to get like people to not, watch him or something, I don't know. Because I know you can't get down there.
Yeah, there's like a couple ways of doing certain things, so I guess that's how you do that. Alright, I'm gonna go talk to Aru then. What book is that? You smelt it. Okay. Aru.
How can I help you, my friend?
That's Source Ender business.
By all means.
Is there any more you can tell me about that? No, he doesn't have anything else. Like, pretty much we're just on the main quest line. I don't know if the captain will have anything for me.
Oh, what now?
Let's discuss Jake's murder.
So, let me get this straight. There are insidious sorcerers running about town that turned a council ambassador into a zombie for sport, after said councillor was murdered by some mystery witch who subsequently trotted off to her cabin in Lucula Woods. Sure you haven't omitted relevant details like flying brooms, black cats, and bloody pentagrams? By Belagar's nevers! Sounds like a fantasy tale mothers tell their children before bed! And I bet none of it's more than fantasy either. Though no doubt Ahu puts stock in your every word. Anyway, be these truths, half-truths, or outright lies, it seems to me your business in Cyseal is concluded. Don't let the undead hit you on the way out.
What a pleasant man. Alright, well that's it. Anything else you want to do here?
No, I think we're good.
Alright, well guys, that's all the time we have for today. Next time, as I said, all combat, so take care everyone, bye.
Toodles!